Hello, let's talk about buttons in SwiftUI. So in this video, we're going to cover a basic usage example. We're going to talk about the button style modifier and how you can use preset button styles. And then if you want to go custom, we're going to show a couple of different examples of custom buttons. And lastly, we're going to dip a little bit into accessibility with buttons. All right, so let's dive into Xcode and take a look at a basic usage example. So here I have an Xcode project. I'm going to get rid of this more complicated button. We will get there, I promise. So in SwiftUI, you can create a new button component simply by typing button with a capital B. And there are a couple of different ones here. Let's use this one, title key in action. So here you can put a string with whatever button text you want. And then for the action, this parameter, you put a code block to execute when the button is tapped on. And a code block is indicated with two curly brackets, like this. In between the curly brackets, you put the code that you want to execute. We'll call it action. And this is what it looks like in the preview. So let me zoom out a little bit so you can see the screen. There's our first little button. Now, I want to warn you that when you do what we just did here, you can also double click or hit enter from here, and it's going to turn this into a shorthand, what's called a trailing closure. So all it did was it took your block of code, right, the two curly brackets, and it moved it behind the rounded bracket, and it took out this parameter label. Right, so we can do it manually like this. So that's just something I want to warn you about, but they are exactly the same thing. This is just a shorthand. And again, this is the where you would execute the action. So this is your most basic button. Let's dive into how to style this button. So if we wanted to, let's say, apply a default style, we can apply the button style modifier to this button component. And there are a couple of different styles that we can use. So inside these rounded brackets, hit dot, and then you can select from five. Let's start from bordered and see how that looks. So that's going to apply this nice gray border onto your button. Now it's a bordered button. Now you might say that's kind of a plain looking button. I want a colored background. So in that case, you want the bordered prominent style. So let's apply that to this button here, and you get a nice bold button. Now, if you want to change the color for that button, you can simply add an additional modifier and change the tint color to green, let's say. Let's take a look at a couple of different other button styles. So this one, we are going to take a look at borderless. If you don't want any border, this is the default button. It actually looks like the basic button. And then lastly, actually not lastly, we have a couple of different ones. We have plain. So this button style just removes all the frills from it. There are no indications for when you're tapping it. See, there's animations, but this one doesn't even have anything and there's no color to it. So this is a very plain button that could probably hide as a label, which would be really confusing for users. So I wouldn't recommend that. And you also have automatic. This is the last one. And automatic is cool because the way that this looks depends on what platform the user is running your app on. So if it is on iOS, if you have your button set to automatic, it's going to take the borderless style because that is what a default button in iOS looks like. However, if your user is using your app on, let's say, macOS, then the default buttons on Mac look like a bordered button. So that's what automatic does. Now let's take a look at a couple of different custom buttons. So I'm going to do that up here. Remember before when I first showed you, we chose this one, button with a title key and an action. Well, this allows you to put a string to represent the button. Now we want to choose action and label. And inside label, we can actually put any other view that we want. And action is the same thing. This is a block of code that you want to run when the button is tapped on. So inside here, let's fill this in first. This would still be to execute the action. Whereas the label now, you can put whatever you want. So right now, by default, it is using a text label called button. But what I've done is I've added an image to this Xcode project called donut. So we're going to try to add that in there. So we're going to use an image view instead, and we are going to put donut. That's really, really big. So we're going to say that it is resizable, and then we are going to constrain its height to, let's say, 40. And we probably want to maintain the aspect ratio. All right, so there's our little donut button. Okay, now let's take a look at an icon with text button. So we type in button again, and this one is kind of the same thing as this one, except that when I hit enter here, it is going to create a shorthand again. So this is actually the action. And this is going to be whatever label I want. Take a look at this. This block right here is this one, right? And then this label part back here is this block of code. But gone are the rounded brackets. So this is just another shorthand way to write this. Let us take a look at an image with icon. So in this case, icon, I'm going to use some SF symbols. So you can download this SF symbols app through, if you just Google SF symbols, you'll find it. And these are all symbols that you can use that's already on the system, and you don't need to add any additional assets to your project. So let's take this one, for example, and we're going to copy the name. And to use this icon, you use an image view with the system name initializer, and then you put in the name as a string. So there we have our icon. I'm going to also add a text label and call, say, upload. So this is now our button. Now, if you wanted an icon only button, that would be the same as this one, except that it would look like that with just the icon. Now, using what you learned in the button style, what we talked about, you could make this a bordered prominent icon button. Take a look at that. You could do the same thing with this one. So you can combine button styles with custom buttons. Now I want to talk about a couple other modifiers that you can use to customize the look and feel of your button. For example, fonts. So if we wanted to change, let's use one of these buttons down here. Let's use this bordered button. So we can use the font modifier, and you can specify a, for example, a system font that's a different size. Well, 10 would be smaller. Let's say 30. And that would be larger. Or perhaps you could specify a one of the different font styles, the default font styles or presets. So you do large title, or perhaps you could do there's headline. It's different styles preset in iOS. So that's how you would change the font. You could even use custom fonts here. Now, we're not going to cover that in this tutorial, but I do have an article on the website covering how to use custom fonts, and I'll link that in the description below if you're interested, but you would use this font modifier as well. You could also use foreground style, and that can change the text color. Maybe that is not visible enough, but there, that's red text. And don't forget the bold modifier, which just makes your text bold. So there are a ton of other modifiers that we haven't covered, but those are some of the basic ones that you can customize the look and feel of your buttons. Now let's transition to talking about accessibility, which is really, really important for your app. If you want to make sure that anybody can read what's on your screen, you can add some labels to your buttons. For the accessibility options like screen readers and things like that. So for example, for this green button, all you have to do is use the accessibility modifier. So that, as you can see, there are a lot of different options here, and I would recommend exploring some of these, but two that I want to point out that you might want to consider adding is this one here, label. It adds a label to the view that describes its contents. So you can apply this to most any components, I believe, on the UI. So you can describe what it is to, let's say, a screen reader. And this one gives a hint on what happens after you tap on the button. So that's very useful as well. Two last things. Here's the video series going through all of the other SwiftUI components, and here you can find a single Xcode project with example code for all of the SwiftUI components. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.